What's up?
Half night to Mexico.
Thanks. My butler. Sounds good. I just did that for dramatic. I did it for dramatic effect. I'm on vacation. I'd like people in the play. Is that okay?
As long as they're quiet.
Okay. Well, I mean, like I said, being in UK where I had to be confident in myself. Because if I wasn't, I would have never made it. Like, I would have just been a little kid to get stuffed in lockers and fed, you know, I was the guy, I guess you could say. I'm over the top, I'll admit that, and I think all my friends would say I'm over the top, but like, life's too short not to be. Like, when I go out, I freaking love calls. I mean, I love, like, attention, I don't mind it. I mean, I love walking into a place, and people are like, oh, look at that fruit game, he's got a bow tie on, he's a fruit. I'm like, yeah, what's up? You know, I don't mind it.
How do you handle it?
I embrace it, and I love it. I think it's hilarious. My mom was getting phone calls from Ole Miss fans because I did this whole spill where I called them white trash. And I embrace it. I love it. Because the girls love it. I don't really care about the guys. The girls are like, oh, my God. Yeah. Dude, girls like assholes. That's what's hilarious. Like, girls are like, oh, what a nice guy. But I'm an asshole, you know. And it's, what does the guy to do, you know? Because the nice guys always finish last, I guess.
So you really
think
that all girls want
to push? 9 out of 10.
That's pretty high.
Okay, now, if they've been hurt, if girls have been hurt in the past, then they'll still settle for, like, the guy who's, like, a 4 out of 10. The guy that's not attractive. The guy that's, you know, a scrub. Because they don't want to get hurt. You know, but every girl in her heart wants to be with a ridiculously good-looking guy, you know, like myself. I know, I get that a lot. That's cool. Yeah. What? Yeah, I mean, like I said, no, I can be very sweet. Like, I give money to people that, if I'm walking by, you know, I live in New Orleans now, and they put out their hand, and they're like, hey, quarter, quarter. I said, yeah, sure. I mean, I can be nice, but, I mean, as far as haters go, I love to, like, put them in their place. And the bow tie always reminds people that I'm better. That's why I love bow ties. It's so classy. I think the classiest people wear bow ties, so.
Let's talk a little bit about
this whole look.
How
are
you doing this whole thing?
What, my bow tie?
Yeah, and your sweater.
You don't like it?
Not bad, you look fine.
Oh, thanks. I mean, it's just me. Like, I feel more comfortable wearing this than I do in a t-shirt. I've never been out, never been to a football game in, like, a t-shirt. Like I said, I feel comfortable like this everywhere I go. So this is how I dress. This is me. You know.
Maybe you tell me a story about a situation where somebody didn't like you, or maybe or your pink white bow tie, and maybe
have
caused a problem.
Oxford, Mississippi. Like I said, I called them white trash. The dean of students sent me an email asking me not to come to Oxford. Now, that's funny enough. Anyway, long story short, my friends were like, you gotta go, because you just called them out. So I hired two, like, my friends, but, you know, they're big, and no one would ever mess with them, and we went to Oxford. I went to Oxford in a white tuxedo with two paid bodyguards when the entire town wanted to kill me. And, like, I've never seen, it was ridiculous. It was like I was Britney Spears, like, killed their dogs. Like, they all hated me, and we had a blast. I mean, because the girls, even though they hate you, they're like, oh my God, I want a picture. Oh my God, cute. But then they hate you at the same time, so they don't even know what to do. But yeah, I had a blast in Oxford. Yeah, it was fun, man. Like, they wouldn't let us in any bars. They said I was a liability. They were like, you can't come in here, JT Bowtie. I was like, all right, man, whatever. But we had a good time. Well, I'm actually wanting to start my own bowtie company. And that's the name of my JT Bowtie. Is going to be the name of my bowtie line.
Why JT?
Jonathan Taylor. My first name is Jonathan. My middle name is Taylor.
So, tell me a little bit about, like, if I had, like, one of your best friends right now, like, what
would you say about you? Beautiful. Now, they would say he's fun. Like, I'm always excited. Like, I'm like a little kid, like, we, like, are going out, like, I'm, like, really, I get really excited about it. Take me too seriously?
Yeah.
No, actually, I'm, like, total opposite. I don't take really anything too seriously. That's, I think that's the problem with everyone that, like, looks at me and judges me for my appearance. I think they are too serious. I'm like, really? Let's have fun, dude. Just let loose. Why not dress up everywhere you go? Life's too short not to. Exactly. That's what makes it funnier to me. That is so ironic. I love it. That's why I like being different, too. I don't want to wear my boots and my tight jeans that show off my bulge. And I definitely don't want to wear, you know, dip, smoke, you know. Just want to be different. I think it's very trashy. Like, I don't know why people do it. Like, it's just terrible for your body, and it's terrible for, like, everything about you. So, I mean, it's their life. They can do it, but, like, I would never kiss or date a girl that smokes a cigarette.
So, when you think about the relationship between you and your life
right now, what's that turn into? Well, I wanted to start my bow tie line right out of college. But I mean, it's very expensive to do. The economy sucks. So I kind of, my parents are very strict. They're like, look, I didn't want to live at home either. So I was like, who will hire me? So I thought to myself, who hires good looking people? Abercrombie & Fitch. So I went and applied at Abercrombie & Fitch, and they were like, yeah, man, you want to be a manager? So I'm actually a store manager down here in New Orleans at Abercrombie & Fitch. Having fun, man. Hanging out. Like, I'm actually in Gulf Shores right now at the beach. Just, I love to play golf. I really want to, you know, be a golfer, be back on the tour. I mean, get on the tour, nationwide tour. Golf is a big passion of mine. So playing, like, golf for a living would be, like, my ultimate dream.
When you go out dressed like this, what kind of reaction
do you get? It's funny because, like, girls, whether or not they want to admit it, they like it. Because they're like, it takes one confident guy to walk into a freaking bar in Alabama in a bow tie and a sweater vest. And their guys like looking at themselves like, ooh, I'm going to make fun of him because my girlfriend thinks he's hot, you know? So I love it. I mean, it's, I don't mind, like, being, like I said, I talked to Damon, I don't mind being the bad guy. I mean, I'm me. You don't like it, it's whatever.
So,
well, it's not just money. High class is someone who, I mean, is just a classy individual. Smoking, no. I mean, like, when I go out, I drink wine, I drink, you know, only the most expensive stuff. I just don't like being around, like, white trash. Like, people that act an idiot, like, get, you know, just, you know, go to the bar and they get drunk, and they're like, oh my God, let's make it out. I'm like, get the freak off me. I don't like going to concerts because people, I don't like being touched. Like, you know, people are all close to you and stuff. I mean, just, it's not just about having money. It's about having classes, like, you know, a character, having a strong character and being confident in yourself. So.
You have a lot of friends.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Check my Facebook. Just kidding, but I don't even know how. I mean, a lot of them, like, when this whole spill with J.P. Bowtie went down, everyone was adding me, and I was just like, I'm not going to be a jerk. I'm going to accept them. So I think, when I called them white trash, a lot of the Greeks, the Greeks at Alabama really hate me more than, like, any other school because they think I made our school look bad, but I don't know. The football team loved it. That's why I kept doing it.
So you don't regret
paying
your
cut off? No. Maybe about other schools. Like, Tennessee, I just, Ole Miss, they call Mississippi State white trash. They're so mean to other people. I just felt Ole Miss needed to be brought down a notch, and I think I did a pretty good job of that.